Hello viewers, welcome back to my channel Computer Engineering Made Easy and I am Anindita. In this tutorial we will be learning how to insert notes in an already created single linked list. If you haven't checked out my tutorial on creating a linked list, please make sure to click the link on the top right corner of your screen. Insertion of notes in a linked list can be done in 5 different ways. The user may choose to insert a note at the beginning of the linked list, or at the end of the linked list, or at any intermediate position. If we try to discuss all methods in one tutorial, the video is going to be too long, so we are going to split it into 2 parts. The part 1 will cover insertion at the beginning of the linked list, insertion at the end of the linked list, and counting the total number of nodes in the linked list, while the part 2 will be dealing with insertion at the nth position, insertion after a node having value n, and insertion before a node having value n. When we want to insert a node at the beginning, there can be 2 cases. The first case is when head is equal to null, and the second case is when head is not null. Head is equals to null means that the list is currently empty, that is, there are no nodes in the linked list. So this is going to be a very straightforward case to handle. In this case, we simply create a new node using the function createNode that has been discussed in my tutorial on creating a linked list. So if you haven't checked it out, please make sure to look for it in the description box. The link is given. So we will simply create a new node, store value in it, and then we shall return the address of this newly created node to the head variable stored in the stack memory. This is going to serve our purpose of creating the first node or inserting a node right at the beginning of the linked list. However, if head is not null, this is going to be a bit tricky. When head is not null, it means that a linked list already exists. So that means there are a few nodes that are already present in the linked list, and the base address of that node is stored in the head variable in the stack memory. So currently the situation is somewhat like this. Now, in order to insert a new node, we have to first create a new node. Once the new node has been created, we store the address of the new node in another variable called temp, which is of type pointed to struct node, and then the insertion process begins. In order to insert this new node before the existing nodes of the linked list, that is at the first position of the linked list, we have to store this address 700, which is stored in head in the next part of the newly created node. So for that, we have to store the value head in the temp next part. And once that has been done, this means that if 700 gets stored over here, a link like this is already established. So once the link has been established, that means the node has already been inserted. Now there is only one step that needs to be done, that is, we have to make this head variable point to this newly created node instead of the existing node. So for that, we write head is equals to temp. This is going to make the variable head point to the newly created node instead of the old node. So now let us take a look at the code, how we can implement it and how it has to be done. So for that, we create a function called struct node insert at beginning and pass the head, that is also of struct node start type, from the main function. So once this parameter is passed to the insert at the beginning function, inside the function we have got 2 cases. So if head is equal to null, this means that there are no nodes present in the linked list. So we are basically referring to case 1. So for this, we simply call the createNode function, and whatever address is returned by the createNode function gets stored in the variable head. However, this else part will be executed only if head is not null. So in this case, the temp is equals to create node, this particular statement creates this new node and then stores the address, that is 500, inside the variable temp. Now temp has to be declared earlier as a local variable, struct node star temp. Once we have created the new node, now we have to establish a relationship between the newly created node pointed by temp and the first node of the list that is currently being pointed by head. So in order to insert the newly created node before the existing node, we have to store the address of the existing first node in the next part of the newly created node. So for that, we write temp next is equal to head, because the address 700, which is the address of the current new node, is stored in the head variable. So therefore, whatever is there in head has to be stored in the temp next part. So for that, we write temp next is equal to head. Once that has been done, then we write head is equals to temp. This means that now, instead of the 700, head will now hold the address of the newly created node, that is 500, indicating that this node at the address 500 is now the first node of the linked list. Finally, we return head. The next case is insertion at the end. In this case, we insert a newly created node at the end of the linked list. Even in this case, when we try to insert a node at the end of the linked list, two cases may arise. In the first case, head may be is equal to null, while in the second case, head may not be equal to null. Again, if head is equal to null, that means there are no nodes in the linked list. This means that if we simply create a new node and connect it with head or store its address in the variable head, then automatically this insertion is done. However, if head is not null, that means there are already certain number of nodes that are existing in the linked list. This means that we have to work in a different way altogether. So right now we have got the first node's address being settled in or being stored in head. Now, if we want to insert a new node, in this particular case, we have to introduce a new pointer called change pointer. This change pointer will be responsible for shifting and identifying the last node of the linked list. So initially, we start with change is equal to head. That means change holds the address 700. Next, we check whether change next is null or not. That means whether any other address is stored in the next part of change or not. If any address is stored in the next part of the node pointed by change, that means change next is not null. And if change next is not null, we shift change. We shift change by writing change equal to change next. So when we shift change, that means instead of 700, change will now hold the address, that is 500. This means that instead of pointing to this node, change will now point to this node. Again, we will check whether the change next part is null or not. Even in this case, we find it is not null. So if it is not null, we again write change equal to change next. That means we shift change. And when we shift change, instead of 500, change now holds the address of the next node, that is 200, indicating that this link no longer exists, but change points to this particular node. Now again, we check if change next is null or not. In this case, we find that the change next is holding null. This indicates that we will break out of the loop and change will settle itself on this particular node. The insertion of the new node will now come into the picture. At this point of time, we shall create a new node and store its address in the variable temp located in the stack memory. So if the address of this new node is 300, the 300 will be stored in the temp variable, indicating that temp is pointing to this particular node. Next thing that we need to do is, in order to connect this node and this node, is that we have to store this address 300 in the next part of this particular node. So for that, we write change next is equal to temp. This particular line is going to establish the relation between this node and this node. So when we write change next is equals to temp, this means that whatever is there in temp will now get stored in the change next part. Change is pointing to this particular node. That means change next is this location. So therefore, we have to store the address 300 over here. And once we do that, automatically this link gets established. Now let us see how we can implement this as a function. So for that, we have this struct node star insert at end struct node star head function. Here also we are passing head as a parameter, and head is being returned back to the calling function, which is the main function. Inside this function, we have got two variables of type struct node star type, temp and change. These two pointers are local pointers to the function and are required to identify the last node as well as to hold the address of the newly created node. Now for the case 1, that is if head is equal to null, we have got the if condition. Here if head is equal to null, we call the function createNode, and whatever address this createNode function returns gets stored in the variable head. If you are not aware of this createNode function, the body of the createNode function has been discussed in my tutorial on creating a linked list, whose link is given in the description box. Please make sure to check it. Coming to the second case, that is if head is not null, we come to this else part. Here we first create the new node, and note that in this case, instead of head, we are storing the address in temp. That means this part gets created right at the beginning. After this, we set change on head, that means change is settled on head. And this loop over here, while change arrow next not equal to null, change equal to change arrow next is responsible for shifting change from the first node of the list to the existing last node of the list. After this loop, change comes and settles itself on the last node of the existing linked list. Next, we write change next is equal to temp. This particular statement is responsible for storing the address of stored in the variable temp, that which in this case is 300, in the next part of the last node of the linked list. And on executing this particular statement, the link between the last node and the newly created node gets established. Finally, we return head to the main function. Before we move on to the case of inserting a node at the nth position, we need to figure out how to count the total number of nodes present in the linked list. So in order to count the total number of nodes present in the linked list, we have to first see how to do that. In order to count the number of nodes in a linked list, we need to first set a pointer on the starting node or the head node of the linked list. Let us call this pointer as temp, and it is pointing to the first node of the linked list. Now, while temp is not equal to null, we keep on shifting temp, and with every shift operation, we count the number of, or we increment the count variable, which keeps track of the number of nodes of the linked list by 1. So for that, we have this function int count struct node star head. Here, the head of the linked list of which we want to count the number of nodes is passed as parameter, and the total number of nodes in the linked list is returned back to the calling function. Since it is an integer, the return type is int. Inside, we have a local variable called c, which is initialized to 0. The c is the counter and is responsible for counting the nodes in the linked list. Next, we declare struct node start temp equal to head. This means that we are setting the pointer temp on the first node of the list, indicating that whatever be the address of this first node, it is present in head as well as the variable temp. Next, we run this loop while temp not equal to null. So temp at this point of time is holding the address of the first node, that is 700, and it is definitely not null. Let the address of the second node be 300, which is stored in the next part. let this be 100, so 100 is stored here. Let this be 500, so 500 is stored over here. This is the current situation that we have. Now, at this point of time, we have found that temp is 700, so that means it is not null. So we execute the next statement within the while loop, that is temp equal to temp arrow next. That means temp will now point to the address 300, which means this link gets broken and temp now points to this particular node. Again, we increment the value of C by this particular statement. So C now becomes 1. Next, we again check if temp is not equal to null. We find that temp is equal to 300. So obviously temp is not null. So the condition becomes true. So we execute temp equal to temp next. In the temp next part, we have 100. So temp will now become equal to 100, indicating that this link no longer exists, but temp will now point to this particular node. At the same time, the count increments to 2. Now again, we check if temp is not equal to null. Temp at this point of time is equal to 100. So obviously it is not null. So we again enter the loop and temp equal to temp next gets executed. This means we again break this particular link and temp now points to the last node of the linked list. Again, counter gets incremented to 3. We find that temp is still not null. Why? Because temp at this point of time is holding the value 500. So since it is not null, we again enter the loop and again we execute temp equal to temp next. At this point of time, in the temp next part, we have null. So therefore, temp now becomes equal to null. And since temp now becomes equal to null, this one has already been incremented to 4. Temp has become null, so we break out of the loop. And finally, we return the counter value, which is 4. So this linked list has got 4 nodes, and therefore this count function is going to return the value 4. Let's run the program and see how exactly the insertion at the beginning works. So when we run it, firstly, this is showing that we are creating a linked list as per the user choice. So if you haven't checked out my function on creating a linked list, please make sure to check out the link given in the description box for creating a linked list. So let the value of the first node be 10. I want to add more nodes, so I'm pressing 1. Let the value of the second node be 20, adding more nodes, so 1. Value of the third node is 30. I don't want to add any more nodes, so 0 to stop. So the content of my list is 10, 20 and 30. Now I am looking forward to insert a node at the beginning of the linked list. So I have to create the node. And what will be the value of the new node that I want to insert? Let the value be 5. So this means 5 gets inserted at the beginning of the linked list, as we can see. Now let us see how we can insert at the end of the linked list. Again, we are calling the function and we have to create the linked list. So the first value is 10. Second is 20, third is 30. I'm not adding any more nodes. So 10, 20, 30 are the 3 nodes in my linked list. And I want to add a node at the end of the linked list. So let the value be 40. So you see, after I have given 40, the content of the list now becomes 10, 20, 30, 40. So all nodes are there.